Hi guys, I'm Monica and welcome back to my channel. And this is my March TBR. Now let's talk about TBRs for a moment because I'm a mood reader. If you don't know what that means, basically is I pick up whatever I'm in the mood for. But I am bad at decision making and then I'm like looking at all of these books I have and I think to myself, oh my god, I have to read a book and there's so many of them and I don't know which ones to read. So that's why I make TBRs. I'm not saying that I'm gonna stick to this TBR 100%, but these are the books that I have so far chosen to read in March. I don't wanna get like shit on for this book that I chose to read in March, but hear me out. I was having a moment with this whole issue in the world that we're not gonna talk about, and I decided that the first book that I'm gonna pick up in March is World War Z by Max Brooks. This is clearly about a zombie apocalypse and what happened in the aftermath of it. And there was a movie made about it, which I've heard has nothing to do with the book. But you know, it's always fun to read a book that a movie was based off of and then see how they butchered it. The next book I plan to pick up in March is If We Were Villains by ML Rio, which is the current kind of baby of dark academia and in BookTube. And well, from what I hear, it's about a murder at a very prestigious kind of Shakespeare-based school for actors and the true story behind said murder. So I'll let you know how that goes. The next book I plan to pick up in March is a graphic novel called The Magic Order by Mark Miller and Olivier Coppiel. And this is book one, and apparently this is like a Netflix show. And I actually have no idea what this is about. I know there's a magical family and apparently it's kind of like Vampire the Masquerade, the role-playing game, where they keep humans safe from knowing about magic. And then that's pretty much all I know. And as you know, I love going into books blind, so I'm really excited about this. And the art style is really, really beautiful. But I, like, look at that. It's, I don't know, there's something about it that really draws me to it. But I don't want to show you more because I've seen some scenes in this and it's graphic. We're talking seriously graphic. Now, next up in March, I'm going to pick up the first book in the Shadow Children, I always want to say trilogy and it's not trilogy. In the Shadow Children series, and that is Among the Hidden. It's about a world where you can't have a third kid, and obviously there are many couples that do for some reason or another, and we follow Luke, who is a third child, and that's all I'm gonna tell you about it. Up next, we have The Man in the High Castle by Philip K. Dick, which is kind of historical fiction, I guess you could say, where the Axis powers won World War II instead of the Allies winning World War II. And that's pretty much all I know about it, except that there is a TV show based off of the book. And I'm kind of worried because Philip K. Dick makes me feel like I both dropped some acid, I'm having a bad trip, and I'm also stupid. But I just keep trying with him, so this is the next book I plan to pick up. I don't know how it's gonna go. I don't know if I'm gonna DNF it or not. We'll see what happens. You'll just have to wait for my March wrap up. The next book I plan to pick up in March is Sword of Destiny by Andrzej Sapkowski. I hope I said that right on the first go. And this is actually my buddy read with my BookTube bestie, Elfie, who's at Ballet and Books, whose link I will leave down below. Please go follow her, she's amazing. But anyway, this is the 0.75. That's literally how they put it. This is the 0.75 book in the Witcher series. And honestly, I loved the first one, which is very rare for me because I tend not to like this kind of high fantasy world building stuff. Words are here for me. But I love the first book and I can't wait to read the second book. I hope it doesn't disappoint me because I really want to continue on with the series. And I kind of want to read Blood of Elves before I watch the TV show, because I'm that kind of person. The next book I plan to pick up in March is The Search for Wondlai by Tony Dietrich-Litzy. And I've gone on about this series and about how this book makes me feel. And I wrote about that on Twitter, and Tony Dietrich-Litzy actually liked my tweet, and I about died inside because that meant so much to me. This book means so much to me, and I'm just gonna reread it. If you don't know anything about it, it's about this girl called Eva 9 who has lived in like this pod her entire life with a robot named Mother, and one day she has to venture out because it's time for her to rejoin humanity, but what she finds is that she might not be on Earth even at all. The illustrations alone are just, they're so gorgeous. They make you imagine this world so well, and I remember when I read it, I was like, this was before the like new Star Wars movies came out. I needed some Star Wars in my life, and this is the closest thing that I have gotten to Star Wars in a very long time. I know I said that about Starsight also and Skyward, but this is like, I don't know, I feel like Eva 9 could be Luke Skywalker. The next book I plan to pick up is actually a scientific book, which is very strange for me, but hear me out. It's called Spying on Whales, and it's by Nick Tyson, I believe is how you pronounce his name. And this book is basically about him studying whales. And I know that sounds really boring, but I think the book is told in such a way where it becomes a story of discovery. And also, I don't think a lot of people realize how little we know about whales and how important it is to be informed about these absolutely beautiful, gigantic, lovely, amazing, and all of those adjectives that come to my mind, animals that live on our planet. And so little of our oceans is explored, and also so much of it is being destroyed, that I think reading these books is really, really important. So I'm very excited to get to this one, even though it's like nothing else that I'm reading this month, or it's actually quite outside of my normal reading habit. The next book I want to pick up in March is Jane Eyre by Charlotte Bronte, and you're not gonna believe this, but I know little to nothing about this book. Or about the story. All I know is that it might be kind of autobiographical, I'm not sure, but I'm really excited to read it. It's one of those classics that everybody loves, and here I am not reading it. What am I doing? Who am I? So I plan to pick it up and read it. I have it in audiobook form, that's why you're seeing the little like graphic over here of it. Up next, I plan to pick up A Long Way to a Small Angry Planet by Becky Chambers. And again, all I know about this book is that it's sci-fi, and I'm guessing they're going to a planet. I don't know much about it. I love to go into books blind. The one thing that I will say is that when I was having my extreme anxiety attacks in December, I asked Reddit for books that wouldn't give me anxiety and would actually make me feel good or make me feel better and stuff like that. And this was recommended over and over again. So that's all I know about it. I'm so sorry that I'm not giving synopsis. It's just that I really love going into books blind. I don't know about you, but that's just how I like to do things. The next book I plan to pick up is Beneath the Sugar Sky by Shauna Maguire. Now, I'm not sure about this one, you guys. I might pick it up. I think I kind of put it in here because it's a short audiobook. Basically, it's once again about kids that go into magical realms and then come back, and they have to deal with the trauma of being in this magical land and also with the trauma of coming back to the normal world. So we'll see if I pick it up. I'm still not sure. And the final book I plan to pick up in March is The Dollmaker of Krakow by R.M. Romero. If you saw my haul, you know what this is about, but if you didn't see my haul, which I will link up in the cards and down below, it's about a dollmaker during World War II, and it sounds actually really magical and cozy, and really a really nice read for spring. My camera just started flashing at me, which is great because that's the last book I plan to pick up in March. Of course, I'm not sure that I'm gonna be able to get through all of these books, but we'll see how many of them I can get through when my March wrap-up comes up. Thank you so much for watching, as always. If you're interested in any of these books, or if you've read any of these books and you like them, you dislike them, please let me know down in the comments. I really appreciate when you guys comment in my videos, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye!